In this video, we're going to take a look at some more flying footage from the Nano Talon. When we left off with the last video, I said I would come back and reduce the aileron throws mechanically using the linkages, which I have done now. As you can see here, we're looking inside the Nano Talon. The aileron servo, the little linkage connectors, the little adjusters, I moved those from the outer holes to the inner holes on the servo arm. And also on the other end of the linkages, I moved those from the inner holes to the outer holes. And that basically allows the servo to move through its full travel while the aileron surfaces move less than they would have previously, if that makes any sense. But what that allows me to do is bump the gains up in the Storm OSD for the roll without it being too sensitive, basically. And the idea behind that is it gives the controller, I guess for lack of a better way to explain it, it gives it more room to think. You know, you can bump your gains up and your servo has a little bit more resolution and less speed, and it's a little bit easier for the flight controller to deal with it. And I've also upped the rates. I had to cut my rates back in my transmitter all the way down to 50% just to keep it manageable, flying in manual mode. So I've stepped those back up. I have high and low rates now at 175%. The first flight we're gonna look at here, it was a rather windy day. It's pretty gusty, windy, coming from the north, which causes a lot of turbulence coming over the flood levee and a tree line, which is just north of me, flying south of that. So it's kind of, it dirties up the air, I guess, is the best way to explain it. But it makes for pretty rough flying, even with my larger airplanes. And the Nano Talon really struggled, and which also makes it nearly impossible to tune the flight controller to adjust those gains. But I did raise the gains. I had to cut those all the way down to 15%. So I was flying it previously on 15% gain for the roll axis. I've bumped that up to 50% for this flight, which is quite a lot higher and back into the normal range for the Storm OSD. And it handled it okay. It seemed like it might have been a little bit high, but like I said, the wind and the wind gust and turbulence was bad enough on such a small and light airplane like this, it's pretty much impossible to really get a feel for how the flight controller is going to work and tune it. So I didn't fly long. I cut this flight short, and I flew the same day later in the day when the wind calmed down a little bit, but it was still about a 5 to 10 mile an hour breeze. So while it was more manageable, it was still less than ideal. But I lowered the gains to 45%, and I left those there or for the remainder of all the flying I done. But what I did, I took off and I climbed a little bit higher, and I flew south out over the fields. I flew all the way out over town, actually. That was just under 2.5 miles. I think if I remember right, it worked out to like 2.45 miles was my maximum distance from home for that flight. And I just, yeah, and I like, I still had that north wind blowing, so I had a tailwind pushing me all the way to town, and I turned around and I fought that headwind coming back. So I didn't push it real far. So like I said, I don't have an accurate amp draw and milliamp hour counter. So I'm just watching my battery voltage, and I didn't want to get caught short, you know, have to land short with a dead battery. So I flew about 2.5 miles out and I came back. Which honestly, for the Nano Talon, that's all I ever asked from it, all I ever expected from it, but it's clearly capable of more. Because when I landed, the battery voltage with no load was, I think, 3.9 volts per cell, a little bit above 3.9 per cell. So there was plenty of reserve left in the battery when I got back from that flight. If I remember right, I think my charger put back about 540 milliamp hours after the flight to top the battery off. And you can clearly see that the milliamp hour counter was way off there, so I'm not going to be able to rely on that. Then the following day was a little bit more calm, so I flew it again, and another change I made this time, I turned off the heading hold in the Storm OSD for PA mode. So in PA mode, I only have roll stabilization, just a leveling. It doesn't try to hold a heading, a compass heading. Is only going to keep the wings level, and the altitude hold is active. But the reason I did that, I noticed before when I was flying in return to home mode or PA mode with heading hold active, when it was trying to hold a specific heading, the plane would tend to wander quite a bit. You know, it would kind of bank left and right, kind of fly in a series of S turns all the way back home. It wasn't flying straight. So I went ahead and disabled the heading hold. I've experienced that with some different airplanes before. I've never had the storm in a flying wing, but I've read that it's a known issue with flying wings. They all do that with the storm. I've seen it in a couple of other traditional fixed wings that I've had the storm in. So I went ahead and disabled it for this last flight to see, and it was a little bit more stable and a little bit easier to hold the airplane level and fly a little bit straighter. Of course, you had to manage your heading with, you know, roll and rudder, whatever, either one. But return to home still snakes a little bit, but at least you can fly in PA mode, hands off, without fighting that little S-turn thing going on there. But with calmer conditions, now this was a light, I would say, 3 to 5 mile an hour wind blowing this day. Normally I would have had, you know, really smooth flights with any of my larger airplanes, but it was still enough. Even the slightest little breeze upsets the Nano Talon because it's so small and light. And there was a little bit of thermal activity going on today with a nice bright sunny day, and I flew it earlier in the morning, you know, kind of mid-morning. So there was some thermal activity going on. So it was still a little bit rough at times. But I did get to chase a bird. One of the big vultures was thermaling, and I spotted him and got a little bit close. And the Nano Talon, I guess it's so small and quiet, they don't seem to mind it. They usually just fly away, get away from the airplane when I fly by them. But he kind of just kept circling around doing his thing. It was still pretty rough flying the little Nano Talon in the thermal, trying to keep up with the bird and keep it in view, as you can see. But it was still fun nonetheless. And another thing I was discovered, there was another bird that I saw that was in some lift. And I started climbing, and normally when I run, you know, at climb throttle and pulling back on the elevator, I was seeing anywhere from about 8 to 10 feet per second climb rate on the USD. And I'm guessing I hit a good pocket of lift here, because it jumped up over, well, right at 30 feet per second at one point, climb rate. So obviously the airplane is so light, it's going to respond to thermal lift quite well if that's something you're looking for. It's not a glider by any means, but it's so small and light, it'll pretty much get sucked away by thermals, I guess. I just thought that was kind of interesting, something to note. But anyway, that's the result of further tuning on the Nano Talon with the OSD, with the mechanical throws reduced in the linkages, and bumped the gain back up in the OSD, so it's got a little bit more room to do its thing. And my opinion on the Nano Talon hasn't really changed. It's still less than ideal, being so small and light with so much dihedral in the wing. It's never going to fly smooth. This is about the best I think you can really hope for without doing some serious design changes to the airplane. But if I were going to go that route, honestly, I think I would probably consider the either the Orbit or the Dart, if you want to stick with the little Zod Nano airplane series. I think either one of those is probably going to have some better flight characteristics as far as handling wind and things like that than the Nano Talon. But the Nano Talon, out of all the flying I've done with it, the most fun I actually had was the initial line of sight flights I did with it. So I may actually pull the Storm OSD out and the UHF gear at some point. If I need them, I'll pull them out. But I'll leave it alone for now and fly it when the opportunity presents itself. But for now, I think it's only really suited for even the most very calm weather days. And as far as this OSD setup goes, like I said, I have trouble with the current sensor. It doesn't work well at the low amp draw that this little motor pulls. So even that's not ideal for medium range flights. But that's about the best I think I can get out of it. it may be a better setup with something like iNav, but once again, like I said, I would rather a much better flying airframe for my first venture into iNav, so I'm not going to put iNav in this one. I'm not sure what I'll do with it. If I do end up pulling some of the gear out, I'll probably end up just keeping it for a little fun line of sight plane. Because like I said, it's all about having fun, and that's the most fun I was able to have with it. So that's going to be it for now. If I get some more footage from the Nano Talon, I will probably post it. But I think in the near to immediate future, I'm going to focus on the AR wing, which I need to get built up and reviewed. So you'll probably see more of that coming up soon, and I'll get back to flying the Banzai wing to try out that little video transmitter that I need to fly and review. So that's what'll be coming up next as soon as I'm able to get to that. So just keep an eye out and subscribe if you're not already subscribed, and thank you to those that are. Thank you for watching the video, and keep an eye out for some more to come.